Hello everyone, in this video I will give a short introduction and starting of how we will start working on Azure DevOps and how we will be learning Azure DevOps. So this will be like a first part of this session, and let's see. So I'll take you guys on my screen and we can start with this session. Okay, so here I am on my screen, and I have already like proceeded a little. But what I'll ask is that go and search for Azure DevOps, okay? And the first link that comes, just open that and sign in. Just open it and sign in. Once you sign in, it will take you to this page, okay? And it will ask you to create a new project. For simplicity, what I will do is I will delete this existing project and we can start, okay? So I am deleting this project, and this is basically the first screen that you are going to see. It will ask you for a project name, description, and who will this project be visible for. You can either choose private or public. If you are making some kind of open source project or an application or an app that you want to share with the world for free, then you can choose public, else you can choose private, and private is the default. So in this video we will just stick with private. When you click over here, you see advanced. In this you find version control. So we have two version control, one is Git and team foundation, or TFS we say, and we have this work item process in version control. So what is version control? Version control is basically tool or a technology that we use to keep track of our software application history. So whenever we create any application, we make iterative changes, we add new features, we fix new bugs. So throughout this process, if we want to track, we use version control, and Git is the most popular version control. For example, you get software updates, right? Like one point, if you install any application, you get a first version of that software, then you get second version, third version, fourth version, right? But if you want to see the history of that version, okay, the history of that app, then you should use Git, okay? And the next we have is work item process. So any development or any project that you work on, it does not happen like today I want to create a project and I can just start creating a project. No, there is a method, there is a process that you have to follow. So in college you might have learned about waterfall model, iterative approach, agile, and those things, right? So DevOps supports these 3-4 methods. These are the most common and most popular, but for this video I'll just stick with the basic what it is already selected, and we can create a new project. So I'll give a small name. I'm creating a project, timesheet project, okay? And I'll just skip the description part, and I will create, click on create project. It will take few seconds to create a project. And also, as I have said earlier, please do not get confused between Azure Cloud and Azure DevOps. Both are completely different things. I have an image with me I want to show. Okay, so take a look at this. On the left side we see we have this circle in the devs, and on the right side we have this ops circle. So in a development, what are the different steps or different activities that we do? We plan the development, we create software, we create the application, then we make the package. Basically, like when you install an application, when an application is created, you basically have a .exe file or .zip file. So that is the final software that you are making, so we call that as a package. And in that process we also have some steps like verification or testing to test if the app is proper or not. So this is the role of a developer, and we have the role of a operation person, okay? So how to release a software, when to release a software, what are the configuration things that we need to do to release that software, and once it is released, how to maintain and how to monitor that. That are the that is a job of an operation person, right? But what DevOps do is DevOps combines both of them and makes one DevOps, okay? And Azure DevOps is one of the website or one of the tool that helps us in achieving all these steps and all this process. So yeah, okay, so I'll again come back to that screen. I have created this project called timesheet, and this is the UI, this is how it looks. You can also explore on your own, okay, all the things over here. But in this video, I'll just give a brief overview slash introduction of how things look here and how to navigate on this portal. First thing you see as a summary, as you go and start creating, editing and do and make some changes, this thing will be populated. You can control it, but it is just like a summary to give you a brief summary of how this project is looking right now. Since we have not done anything right now, we have not set up anything right now, so it is all empty and all blank. Okay, and here I have a section of dashboard. So when you have started working on this project and all your team members are working, you can add widgets over here to see the status of your projects, how much it has completed. You can just add charts. Okay, I will not cover all those charts and tools over here, but I'll just show in future videos how to work with all of these charts. Okay, and then we have something called as wiki. Wiki is like a website for this project. So if anyone wants to know more about this project, what this project is about, so they'll it will be like a document. Okay, so I will cover this in later video, but right now I'm just giving you a brief overview. So it will be like a Wikipedia of our project, just like a page or just like a simple website. We can create a wiki over here so that new people or new employees that will be working on this project will get to know what this project is about and how to change and what to change. Okay, basically your documentation. Then we have a boards section, and in boards we have a work item. So this is the place where we do project management. If I want to create any task, if I want to create any new feature in my application, if I found any new bug in my application, then I will create all those over here and I will assign it to the respective person. Suppose if I found any issue in my application, like sign in page is not working. Okay, I found some issue and I'm saying that sign in page is not working. I'm assigning this issue to this person, and now it is his responsibility to work on this. As soon as this thing is fixed, this issue is fixed, he can just say it is in doing state, then can change it to done state, right? So to track your project for a complete project management, we have this part, boards part, and this same thing will also be shown as a board over here. Okay, you see, so this is like a Kanban style board. You can just move it around and change its status. Then we have something called as backlog. Backlog is like a list of all the things that we have to do, that we need to do. And from this place, manager will assign you all the tasks or all the things that based on the priority and different things from here. So I will show you in later videos how to navigate around backlogs and what are sprints, queries and delivery plans. Okay, just for the simplicity and not making this video very lengthy, I'll stop about boards here. Then we have repo. So you remember I said Git, we have Git to keep track of our project and see how our project evolves over time. And Git also helps in if multiple people are working on the same project, on the same code, then also the Git helps. And also I have already created a video on Git, I'll link it here or here. Okay, and if you have not watched, if you don't know how to work with Git, then Git is very important. You need to have knowledge of Git to be a DevOps engineer. Okay, so please do check that. Also, so here you have all the options related to a Git repository. We have, once we create a Git repository, we will see all our files over here. I'll just do initialize. Okay, so all our code will be here. If we make any changes, we do the commit. If we want to push any changes, we do the pushes. Then we can create a new branch to work on our own changes. It is little complex if you don't know, but if you know already, then these are very simple things. Then we have something as pipeline. So pipeline is where the main advantage of a DevOps come, and this is where the DevOps are needed. So if you want to make any build of any application, or if you want to deploy any application, there is basically a very, very lengthy and tedious process. So if you want to, a software is complete and you want to deploy this in production, then the step is very lengthy. For deploying it on production, you will have to build machines, okay? You will have to build those machines, then you will have to take approval from your manager, then manager will have to take approval from their manager. Your applications needs to be done for automated testing. There are some things that you have to check if the code is compliant or not. Then you can create a pipeline. That pipeline will automatically build, deploy, ask for approval from your managers. And once all it is approved, it will automatically deploy on production. So it basically just makes the deployment and building process a lot easier. Okay. And then we have something called as test plans. So exactly for whatever project we work on, we also do testing of those project, and for that we have this section in test plan. And we have artifacts. For the time being, we will skip artifact. I'll just tell you in one line. If you have ever worked on NuGet packages or NPM packages, then this section is like your personal NuGet package repository or a personal NPM package repository. So in case if any day NuGet gets down, you will have your own repository. So these are all the simple and by default options that we have available over here that I have gone through in this video. But depending on the configuration and changes, we can have few more options available over here, or we can also hide some of the options. If suppose, for example, in my project, I won't be using these two things, artifacts and test plans, then I can just hide those. Okay. So this was a basic overview, a simple overview of this project, of this Azure DevOps. And from future videos, I will take one by one. I will explain all these topics one by one, and we will go into detail. We will create our own code, our own repository. We will see how to create pipeline and how we'll be deploying a project. Okay. So without increasing the length of this video, I will stop it over here, and I will suggest if anyone is watching, then to follow it with me in these videos, and we will make good progress. Okay, so I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.